Hello, my name is Tricia Gladys Johnson. I am 14 years old. I live in Hillsborough, New Jersey, and I am a dragon. I'm just your average teenage girl. I'm a freshman at Hillsborough High School. I like to hang out with my friends, watch TV, and when I come home, I do transform into my dragon self and embody a dragon. The reason I like to come here is just because I feel at home in nature, if that makes sense. I just love, you know, the trees. It really reminds me of my the dragonism and what I believe is important to me. So I just love to come and sit here and really just breathe it all in, you know? This is actually a question I get a lot when I tell people that, yes, I am a dragon. As I mentioned earlier, I can tell you probably weren't listening to me, but after I come home from school, that's when I transform from my human self into my dragon self, so it's more of a transformational process. The way I like to think about it is think of a caterpillar becoming a butterfly. This is me, Tricia, becoming a dragon. It's a really complicated process.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
Hello.
Where were you?
At the Sourlands.
At the Sourlands doing what?
Rituals.
What kind of rituals?
Dragonism.
Would you cut the shit with this dragonism?
Please!
You are not a dragon. You're a 14-year-old girl.
I am a
14-year-old
dragon.
14-year-old girl, no dragon. You're a 14-year-old girl.
Where do I go at night?
Saudi Arabia.
Oh,
stop acting like a nut job.
No, you don't understand.
You're not a dragon. You're a 14-year-old girl.
Screw you.
You're not a dragon. You're a 14-year-old girl. Stop acting like a nut job.
Screw all of you.
I don't know where the hell it went wrong. I mean, she's batshit crazy. I mean, who thinks they're a dragon? I mean, maybe after my wife died, this has gotten worse. Or maybe my wife, buffered this or entertained this somehow. I mean, my wife's a little bit batshit crazy too, so maybe they're both two cuckoos. I don't know. But this is pretty ridiculous. She's not a dragon. She thinks she's a dragon. I can't accept that. It's out of the question.
Sorry, sometimes my emotions get the best of me. It's just hard. My dad, he doesn't understand me. He doesn't support me. He believes I am not a dragon. Countless times I tell him I am a dragon, and it's just really hard. I don't know what it is. I used to have a family that supported me, you know? It wasn't always so hostile in my home. This is my journal where I write down, you know, my thoughts when I ate. And this is actually a picture of my mother, Helene. She died a couple years ago when I was 11, a tragic accident. She was the only one who ever really supported her daughter identifying as a dragon. You know, I always said, Mom, I'm a dragon. And she said, if you're a dragon, you're a dragon. My dad was never on board with this. So that's why, you know, we don't get along anymore. But lately I've been coping with this by, I actually have an internet community. I'm not afraid of stranger danger. I have people all over the world who identify as dragons. We come together and we support one another, you know. We talk about our trips, our fire breathing, you know, where we fly at night. It really helps me get in touch with my dragon self. You know, there are people all over the world, East Sudan, India, Bangladesh, China, Bridgewater, they're everywhere. So why don't I actually just show you? Okay, so this is the page. It's the Dragonism Support Community. Let's just take a little ponder. This is a post that I actually just organized. You're actually lucky that this is the time you're catching us, Dragonists, because we are having our international meetup this Saturday at Local and Van Park. I'm not saying this is going to be amazing, but you tell me. So, see, all these people have RSVP'd already. They seem to be pretty excited about it, if you ask me. Let's see here. Yup. This one's pretty special. His name is Lewis. He's actually kind of like my online lover. And let's just look at his page. This is Lewis. He's right here on the right. He's really quite handsome. We talk almost every day because we are official. Let's see. We're so flirty. You guys don't want to see this. So embarrassing. So that's really it for my social media. I really just use it to get in touch with my dragon self and explore the other dragonisms in the world. It's really quite special, so thanks for asking, and I guess we'll see what happens at the meetup on Saturday. I love school, you know, I have a passion for it. There's just something so exhilarating about coming to school and walking under the fluorescent lights, especially for me, because they do remind me of flying near the sun and the moon, which is my favorite pastime. And you know, I just really love school. I love hanging out with all my friends, you know, Tracy, Malcolm, Celeste. It's so fun, you guys. So second period is almost starting. I'm gonna be late to class, so come with me or don't come with me, but you should probably come with me because it's gonna be really fun. So let's go.
You're late, Tricia.
Sorry.
Hey, do you have a pencil?
That girl's weird as shit.
Yeah, she's got some shit going on. She has like Tourette's or something.
Oh yeah, no, she'll like randomly just in the middle of class just screech and like squeal. It's so weird.
Yeah, I mean, I'd tap though.
Outfit.
Oh, well, it's actually just my favorite Marvel superhero shirt.
Oh, really? What's your superpower?
Oh, wow. I can fly.
Maybe you should fly to the store and get a new pair of tights that doesn't have holes in them.
Or has money been tight lately?
Oh,
I'm
gonna miss the bus.
You got to see Sydney.
It's so funny. Everyone, so it's me, Trish. I'm at Anvan Park waiting for everyone to show up to the first annual Dragonism meetup. And you guys, I'm so excited. I'm just here waiting for everyone. I brought some snacks, and they were supposed to be here about a half hour ago, but I could tell there's a lot of air traffic today in the dragon community, so they're probably just running a little late, you know. And
I'm Lewis.
You look different.
Yep. Yeah. I'm here for the Dragon Rendezvous.
Okay.
Let's get started.
Alrighty then.
Wow. Lewis really is better looking in person. Wow. So, other people were actually supposed to show up, but I think they're, you know, running a little late.
Agreed.
Yeah, so, when did you first identify as a dragon?
I would say around 4 years old when I started coughing and sneezing flames.
That's pretty peculiar, because most dragons don't get that ability until they're at least 12 years old.
Must have been an early bloomer.
Bizarre. Hmm.
Indeed.
1, 2, 3! Oh my god.
Oh my god. They're so weird.
In on this too?
I don't know. What are you guys doing here?
We're here for the meeting.
How did you hear about this?
Nice Facebook page, Trish.
How did you hear about that?
What, did you think those people were actually dragons?
Look at her. Oh my god.
Those profiles.
So weird.
Were you?
Did you actually think there was such thing as a real life dragon?
Are you even a dragon, Lewis? Lewis!
Oh, Lewis!
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
that I had a whole community of people who understood me, who got what it was like to be a dragon. No one gets it. Those witches, my father, you probably don't get it, but the truth is, I am a dragon.
Trisha?
God damn it, Lewis!
Look, Trisha, I am really, deeply, truly sorry for lying to you about not being a dragon. You know, I am just so thoroughly intrigued by your confidence and your abilities. It's truly just mind-boggling.
Oh, Lewis, I forgive you, but can I show you something? Come with me.
Why'd you bring me here, Trisha?
Lewis, I brought you here because I need to end this once and for all.
Huh?
I'm sick of everyone bullying me. My dad, the girls at school. I just need to be free of this life.
What?
Goodbye.
Wait.
Holy shit!
Holy
shit!
Oh my god.
Someone call 911! Trisha! Wait! Should we get the camera?
Holy shit, you fucking... Isn't she beautiful?